Thank you very much. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Before I make my remarks, I invite the Chief Justice, Emeritus, to make his remarks. I would like to invite Justice Ibrahim Mohammed, the acting President of the Supreme Court, to make some remarks.
My name is Mohammed Ibrahim, and I would like to recognize all those present here, from Chief Justice Emeritus, and all other guests, Professor Makau, George Igoro, thank you for inviting me. I'm here only as a guest, just like you. Come and have fellowship with you for this evening in your farewell dinner for Dr. Willy Mutunga. For me, this is your night. This is your night, all the members who are here, particularly civil society, particularly the actors in the sector of human rights. We have had our share of fellowship with the community at the judiciary, and you have said so much there. I don't wish to water down what has been said and what is going to be said by the community's colleagues in the human rights sector. But all I can share with you is that I have known Willy for a long time. I first met him in 1978 when I joined the university. He taught me, he was my teacher. And then back at the floor. And 78 and 79. Later on, when he became chairman of Kenya Law Society, the Law Society of Kenya, I happened to be elected as one of his council members. So we served. Although for some reasons I didn't finish the whole term, I decided to quit earlier and concentrate on my practice, which I started after I left for a real meeting. So it's a long journey, and I'm proud to be here. He has been my mentor and friend, and many things, many values and virtues which I believe I hold, I believe that he imparted on me and he taught me. He was also my dissertation master, and he taught me industrial relations, Lebanon and relations. And I did the topic in the dissertation, job security in Kenya, in which I think I did well. Yeah, so you can see how far we've come along. So I'm very proud to have worked with him as Chief Justice. I've learned so much as a judge of the Supreme Court. He has mentored us, he has given us leadership. And the jurisprudence we have, and which I believe you continue reading, and you have seen some, of course, have been criticized, but that's about law, that's about development of jurisprudence. But he has single-handedly led us, and we believe that he has left the judiciary a stronger place, a stronger institution. And I had already wished him well. And I'm glad that he has been urged that he should not think about retirement. That he's in Asia, and wherever he's going to serve, he's serving as also a representative of Kenya. Therefore, we are still together, and we hope that we'll be going to him for guidance and counsel from time to time. So, thank you very much for having me this evening.
Thank you very much, Mohammed. Tonight is indeed Willy's night. the particular moment in which we sit is one that is fraught with risk. Risk about everything that many of you in this room are fought for. Risk about the things that Dr. Mutunga has fought for his entire life. You know, they say that if you want to walk fast, you should walk alone. But they also say that if you want to walk far, walk together. I think that truism defines the character, the person, the temperament, and the wisdom of Dr. Willy Mutunga. I have known Dr. Mutunga for a long, long time. And there are some things that define him. And many have been spoken about tonight. And I don't wish to repeat those. I just wish to say that in many societies, there are spaces of virtue and there are spaces of viciousness. There are spaces of virtue and there are spaces of viciousness. The space of virtue in this country is also the conscience of this country. And that space is the space that is occupied by civil society, by you who constitute the majority of the people in this room. It is that civil society, that space of virtue, that space of the national conscience, which gave birth to Dr. Mutunga, and he in turn gave birth to it. I think all of you will agree with me when I say that there's hardly anyone in civil society in this room, save for who has not passed through the hands of Dr. Mutunga's membership in civil society. There's nary a lawyer in this room who has not been taught by Dr. Mutunga. For me, that is the legacy of a true intellect. Myself and my inner Kiai and Kiai Murungi, yes, Kiai Murungi, and Peter Karedi, we formed the Kenya Human Rights Commission together in exile. Dr. Mutunga was not in exile, but he was abroad at the time. At the time that we formed the commission, we did not imagine that the commission would become what it has become. Way back in 1991, Dr. Mutunga gathered all of us in North America, and it was under his inspiration and his guidance that we formed the commission. And I think I do not brag when I say that the commission became, in effect, the father of the human rights movement, or the mother of the human rights movement in Kenya. And but Dr. Mutunga never really left the commission, even after he went to the Ford Foundation and later went to the judiciary to become the Chief Justice. He would always call me and ask me how we were doing. And in fact, offer critiques. And some of them stated. He would tell me quite often and chastise me that we were losing our way, that we had lost the fire in our belly. Because, you see, Dr. Mutunga is one of those rare human beings who never tires of a struggle, never tires of change and the struggle for change. And that is why so many young Kenyans are attracted to him today, including so many who are here today, including the young man who was, singing him just a minute ago. For my own behalf, Willy, what can I say? You know, you are my earliest and most influential mentor. And I do not want you to own my mistakes. I want you to just own those things that I've done right. That's it. I just want to say that I personally would not be standing here in front of you today or be who I am today without Dr. Mutunga. And so I know that, these moments when a society gathers to sing accolades to a person are risky because the society is telling you something. Perhaps the society is telling you that you are over the hill. But I know that will not be the case here today. And I don't want you to take this moment of adoration where we embrace you in our love as a moment in which we are telling you to go off into the sunset. Not at all. In fact, just this afternoon I asked the Kenya Human Rights Commission, the Board of Directors, to invite Dr. Willy Mutunga back to come up to resume his position as a board member. I hope that he will give the answer to that question when he speaks. I look forward to reading your memoirs. I hope you write them. Because in the many years that we have known each other, I know the vast knowledge, the witticisms that you have in your head, the rich history that you have. And I hope that you put it down on paper. And I also hope that in that process, you will talk to us about the struggles that you faced and the victories that you achieved in your tenure as Chief Justice of this Republic. And today, I just want to say that we welcome you back because you never left us, really. You've always been with us and you will continue to be with us. And so it's with great, great pleasure that I ask you to come here and share a few thoughts with us.